gonna sing it like this. Hey, people, remember what you say, what you got in your hands today, and you got a choice to play. Hey, Bala Rangers have come to say, big up, big up, big up, big up, touch people, my people. I want stuff for them, but
hello, my name is David H. Thomas, and I'm a member of the group Infinity, and we represent the best of Africa. And I'm hanging out with Shoggy on Tosh Mag Show. Don't change that channel.
Tosh Magazine TV Show, hosted by Shoggy Tosh, brings to you the best of lifestyle, entertainment, sport, films and events. Interesting guest here today. He's a brother of mine. I grew up watching him, so I'm not saying he's old, he's not, he's young, but I too have been watching football, you know, from I couldn't play, you know, you see me, the best I can do is put on a jersey. If you give me a ball, I can't even raise the ball very well, but I like enjoying good stuff, you know, on the TV. And I remember this particular guest of mine in Scotland 89, though he didn't play, this is the under 17 tournament in Scotland 89. That time I was in secondary school, I was in my final year. And I remember watching, you know, that tournament. Everyone thought Nigeria would win the tournament, but Saudi Arabia beat us and they actually won the tournament. And I remember him, though he didn't feature in that tournament, but he was to feature in the under 20 World Cup and also play for Super Eagles, that's the Nigerian national team. He's an icon in Nigeria. He's still an icon. And I'm privileged to introduce him to you. I have with me, I call him Chief, Benedict Akwuegbu. How are you?
Thank you very much. I'm very fine.
Yes, and how's the family?
The family is fine.
Yeah, I must say you have a lovely, lovely family.
Thank you.
Thank you. I know you just you traveled. You just came back a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
And you're a traveler. We Yorubas would say Ajala.
Yeah.
It's a term we give people that travel all around the world. You've traveled to so many countries, but yeah. Currently you're in England. Playing for Basingstoke,
yeah.
Town. How do you compare being here to the other, like Austria, Germany, China, other places you've been to?
Yeah, I think the English people, they are very friendly.
Okay.
They love foreigners a lot. And here they speak English. I think I like it better than the other countries.
Lovely.
Because at least I can understand what they say.
Lovely. I'll just divert a little bit to this beautiful shirt just behind me. That's your shirt.
Yeah.
Memories. I'll just let you blow your horn a little bit about that shirt.
Yeah, it's
I can feel the heat.
It's the World Cup, 2002 World Cup. The jersey is my jersey.
Wow.
Yeah, 2002 World Cup in Japan, Korea.
Japan, Korea. Yeah. Was that the first time you went to Asia?
No, it's not the first time.
By then you've been playing in China before.
Yeah, I played in China before the World Cup.
Yes. Yeah. Especially about that game, the English game where you played, Nigeria played England, we drew 0-0.
Yeah.
Any memories, anything you remember at all?
Yeah, it's always on my mind, you know, the stadium, the players I played against, you know, it was fantastic, you know, to play at the World Cup.
Wow.
It's something special because you meet the best players in the world. It's difficult for me to forget the memory of the World Cup.
At the end of the match with England, which was 0-0, you did change a jersey with
David Beckham.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. And you still have it?
Yeah, I still have it. Yeah.
Wow. Also, in the 2002 World Cup, we played Argentina as well.
Yeah.
They beat us 1-0. anything you want to say? Because the reason why I said that is they always seem to get the better of us, you know, especially in the World Cups. They beat us in the Olympics, the recent Olympics in Beijing. Mm. You know, they although we beat them in the 1996 Olympics, but in the Under 20 World Cup, they beat us. The World Cup 94, they beat us. 2002, they beat us. And again, we are with Argentina in this coming World Cup. So anything you remember about that match? Any tips from
yeah,
you?
Yeah, I think Argentina, they are one of the strongest teams in the world. So they are very, very strong.
Yes. Mm. I remember that match. You actually took a picture with Gabriel Batistuta after the Argentina game. Yeah. Yes.
It's my favorite striker.
Wow. So. Anything about his qualities?
He's very powerful. He can shoot from long distance.
Mm. Interesting. I want to go to another interesting part. We had a lot of responses from your fans. I don't think you guys really know the impact that you have on we, your fans, all over the world. We posted this interview on our website, though we do have a lot of subscribers, but we got close to 1,000 responses. So I don't know if you do have that thought, you know the impact that you as a footballer, you know, have over millions and millions of people. I'll just put that to you.
Sometimes as a footballer, you know, and sometimes you don't know.
We would like to go through some of your pictures. You do have a lot. And I'm proud of you because at times some players, they don't keep memories.
Okay,
I would just like to go through some of the pictures. You have some lovely pictures.
This is the FA Cup.
Okay.
The Australian FA Cup.
Okay. Was that in 2002?
It was in
2000.
Yeah. And I scored all the goals.
Wow.
Gave them the cup.
Tell us about the match.
We played about 6 games.
Wow.
And I scored goals in all the 6 games and I put them in the final.
Wow. So you actually scored in every round?
Yeah, in every round I scored.
Wow.
In 2000.
Wow, wow. And this is the one we were talking about earlier.
Yeah, this is with Gabriel Batistuta.
Wow.
After the game.
Wow. amazing stuff. One of my favorite ones.
And this is with David Beckham.
Wow.
Before the England game.
That was before the England
game. Before the England game, yes.
If you can just tell us, how does it, you know, when you're playing a game, like, for instance, that was the first time that you would, your first World Cup.
Mm.
Yes. How does it feel? Do you get nervous?
I don't get nervous because already I played the Champions League with Grasa Aga.
Yes.
So I played against big teams like Monaco.
Yes.
Yeah. So I did not feel nervous.
Wow. I could imagine if I'm in a stadium with 50,000, 100,000 people screaming my name, man, I don't even know what I would do. But thank God I'm not a footballer. I'm just Shoggy Tosh. So thank God. God knew what he was doing when he didn't make me to be able to be a footballer. This is a very interesting a picture. And from this picture, although we'll go through the others, I'll just throw some questions that your fans sent to you.
Okay.
But this is so touchy, and I'll tell you why.
Mm.
Though we have a very good team at the moment, we have a good team in Nigeria.
Mm.
But looking at this picture, I believe that we didn't really know the potential, how good you guys were in this tournament.
Mm.
I want to believe this was the 2000 and...
This is 2000 Nations Cup.
2000 Nations Cup.
We were in the final. Against Cameroon.
Wow.
We lost on penalties.
Wow.
It was a pity, you know.
I remember. I actually cried. Sorry, guys, you know. Guys do cry as well. I was here in England and, you know, I watched all the matches on Eurosport. But, I mean, here, we have a question actually on Godwin Opara that was sent.
Yeah.
It's Godwin Opara. I remember Pele saying from the Score 99 that he will be one of the best players to ever come out of Africa.
Yeah, it was real.
Wow. And then George Finidi.
Yeah,
I know you. You're passionate about Finidi.
Yeah, it's the best. I think.
Ikechirumu.
Yeah.
Well, I have Taribo West.
Babayaro.
Celestine Babayaro. Kanu Mutiu Adekwaju.
Yeah. Which is a very disciplined player.
Wow.